We'd like to thank all the parents for the commitment.
Hello, everyone. Resurrection Sunday is a very special day for all Christians around the world. It is a day where life defeated death, where light defeated darkness, and where goodness defeated evil. But it didn't just happen in one day. It was a journey, a long, long journey. It all started when God sent his only beloved son, Jesus Christ, to be born in a simple manger. He lived like us but without sins, and he loved us to the end. I'd like to take you with us to the journey of love, and we hope you enjoy it. But first, I'd like to tell you, Happy Resurrection Sunday in English, Feliz Resurrecto Domingo in Spanish, Corazón Agotadín in Arabic, and my favorite Coptic, but you have to help me out. What is it again? Efectos en este.
Efectos en este.
Here is Journey of Love. Christianity. When you open me every day, you will find something new on how to be a good Christian and how our God is a God of love.
Easter's on the corner, you guys, and there's so much I want to know about Jesus and the miracles he did.
I want to know everything, how it all started and how Jesus came to earth.
I know the Bible.
The Bible?
Yes, the Bible has everything we need to know. Come, I see the Bible. Let's go open it.
Good morning, Bible.
Good morning.
We have many questions about Jesus and how he came to earth and did miracles and died for us. Can you take us on this journey?
Yes, yes, and how he died on the cross to save us from our sins.
Okay, let's begin. I call the Jesus journey on earth this journey of love.
Journey of love? What do you mean?
You will know what I mean after I tell you the whole story. It first starts on a holy night.
Tell us how, Bible.
Matthew 8, it is written, "Now when he got into a boat, his disciples followed him, and suddenly a great tempest arose on the sea, so the boat was covered with waves, but he was asleep."
"Jesus, Jesus, help us. The wind and the waves of the sea are so strong. Please help us, we are perishing."
"Why are you fearful, oh, you of little faith?"
Jesus arose and rebuked the winds and the sea, and there was a great calm. Everyone in the ship was amazed that even nature feared and obeyed Jesus Christ.
Bible, I heard Jesus accepted everyone, even the sinners that no one wanted to talk to. Can you tell us a story about that?
Sure. One day, Jesus was traveling. He got tired and stopped at Jacob's well. A Samaritan woman came to draw some water.
"I'm a Samaritan. How can you ask me for such a thing?"
"If only you knew what God gives and who's asking you for a drink, he wouldn't ask me. He would give you the life-giving water."
"You don't even have a bucket and the well is deep. How are you going to give me the life-giving water?"
"Those who drink this water will get thirsty again, but those who drink the water that I will give them will never be thirsty again."
"Sir, give me that water so I will never be thirsty again."
"Go call your husband and come back."
I don't have a husband."
"You are right, for you are married to five men, and the man you are living with now is your husband, not your husband."
"I know that the Messiah will come, and when he comes, he will tell us everything."
"I am he."
Come and see the man who told me everything. He is the Messiah. He is the Messiah."
Just from one woman, a whole town believed in Jesus.
"Wow, that's amazing. Just so one woman was able to change the minds of many people?"
"Yes, because she had faith."
"So faith makes miracles."
"Of course. Let me tell you about another story. One day, Jesus was surrounded by many people, and there was a man named Jairus whose daughter was very sick." As he went to Jairus' house, there was a woman who was bleeding for 12 years.
"I went everywhere and no doctor was able to heal me, but I have faith in Jesus. I know if I only touch his clothes, I'll be healed."
"Who touched me?" "Jesus, there are so many people and we're all crowded. Somebody touched me because I felt power coming out of me."
"I didn't know.
Daughter, be of good cheer. Your faith has made you well. Go in peace."
"But what happened to Jairus' daughter?"
"By the time Jesus went to her home, she was dead."
"Oh no.
Don't be upset. When Jesus arrived to her home, he said to her mom,
'Do not weep, for she is not dead but sleeping. Little girl, arise. Give her something to eat.'"
Do you want to know about the miracle of feeding 5,000?
"What? 5,000 people? My mom can barely feed us."
One day, the multitude were gathered to hear Jesus and to talk with him. So the disciples said to Jesus,
"Jesus, send the multitude away so they can go to town and buy food. You should give them something to eat."
"We have only two fish and five loaves of bread. How is that going to be enough for them?"
"Father, bless this food."
"Glory be to God, look at all this food."
Multitude and how happy they are.
So they all ate?
Yep, and there are 12 baskets left over.
That's amazing.
What's amazing is the woman who washed Jesus' feet with her tears at the Pharisee's house. A woman who was a sinner came to the house and started pouring oil onto Jesus' feet.
I have nothing to offer but this expensive oil. How I wish to pour it on your feet, Jesus.
I came to your home and you did not wash my feet, but she washed my feet with her tears. So her sins are forgiven, for she loved much. Your sins are forgiven.
Son of man with a kiss?
do something bad for Jesus, but you wouldn't expect his close disciple to deny him.
A disciple denied him? Which one?
Peter. He denied him three times, and he felt sorry. After that, he wept the whole night, asking God for forgiveness.
Hey, I know you. You're one of Jesus' disciples.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are. I've seen you with him before. You are a disciple.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Yup, you're pretty sure one of his disciples. You sound exactly like him.
No, I'm telling you, I don't know what you're talking about. I'm not his disciple.
Because he bowed me, he loved me, he lifted me above. Because he This was very impressive.
Everybody look up here. Look up here. Look up here. Everybody look up here. Look up.